Well, you know, if you buy an honest product and you can see what it is, then the product is the product is the promise. So you can see that here in this model. And this is the first thing what you see when you're in the supermarket. It is, okay, well, what's the benefit for me when I buy this? If you have time, most people don't have time, but then you can find some form information about the company itself. So its origin, its purpose, what are their concerns? If they have a lot of resources needed, but there's only a few left in the world, then they should change their strategy. If they don't, it's short-term policy, so you shouldn't buy the product anyway. But so, and here is where the trust actually starts. But it's not full trust because it's not social. So what you do is with these products, it's like this bottle again. I just use it because I have it here. But what you do is you show it to your friends, right? So okay, first you check, is it a good product? Okay, is it durable? Is it long-lasting? Whatever, how it's made, and then I'm showing you it to you, and you say, "Oh yeah, you have a top of one. I've only that one."
Mine is broken, by the way. It fell
no,
down.
No, no, no. You don't have to apologize. This is great advertising in the way that you do it, because you now you want to join in. This is social proof. This is exactly what happens. Okay, so if you say no, it's a horrible product, the trust stops immediately. So sometimes you have great brands with great products, but if the common people don't like the product, even if it's the best product in the world, there are a lot of product failures because the people didn't get it. They didn't like it. What way? And when you, and then here, this is the bonding part. Now it's becoming very important, because if you walk with this bottle, it's part of my identity.
Yeah, it's a status.
Yes, social status, yeah, but it's part of me now.
Yeah.
It's not like this now it's a product, right? But if I'm wearing it, I'm showing it to you, and I'm a great person. Now it's the brand personality becoming my personality. So now it's very important that you have a brand fit, so that the values of the organizations match my values. And if here is a misfit, not a brand fit, then you lose trust also. So, and this is the loop which you can always make with branding. If you build a sustainable, strong brand, first you have to look at your own company. It's inside, internal branding it's called. So what are your values? What are your the purpose, vision, mission? So what kind of message and which product are you sending into the world? Is the product in that sustainable? Is it good? You know, is it durable? Is it payable? And then if you buy it, you're talking with other people. So this is part of the partaking. So so you don't have actually a bonding, let's say, for coffee beans. But for Starbucks, you have a bonding. A lot of people are going to Starbucks, not for the beans. They say it's great coffee, but that's not the point at all. No. Because the values of the Starbucks matches with their own values. They want to be an urban citizen or whatever, an urban dweller and cool or whatever. They don't like it if you say it like this, but that's of course what happens.
Yeah, if you build it down there on your layers of their behavior, it's like they
Yeah,
want to belong to somewhere.
yeah, but
Yeah.
it that makes them
They want to
vulnerable.
be cool.
Yeah, yeah. But because if you strip everyone naked, then everyone is the same, right? So we're all wearing the monkey suit, that's what I always say. Yeah.